God's signs in the skies and on earth. This set of verses is one of my favorites in the Quran. All right, so there you go, another one of my favorites. And these verses that we'll discuss, they are the verses that are usually recited before performing Salatul Layl, that night prayer that one does and is in total intimacy with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and closeness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because it is a salat that is performed in a time of the day or night which usually people are not willing to do that. And it takes some time, it takes some sacrifice from them. But there are some who want to do that because they want to get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. These are verses 190 of Surah Al-Imran all the way to 194. So all in all, five verses. It says, إِنَّ فِي خَلْقِ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَاخْتِلَافِ اللَّيْلِ وَالنَّهَارِ لَآيَاتٍ لِأُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ الَّذِينَ يَذْكُرُونَ اللَّهَ قِيَامًا وَقُعُودًا وَعَلَى جُنُوبِهِمْ وَيَتَفَكَّرُونَ فِي خَلْقِ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ رَبَّنَا مَا خَلَقْتَ هَذَا بَاطِلًا سُبْحَانَكَ فَقِنَا عَذَابَ النَّارِ رَبَّنَا إِنَّكَ مَنْ تُدْخِلِ النَّارَ فَقَدْ أَخْزَيْتَهُ وَمَا لِلظَّالِمِينَ مِنْ أَنصَارٍ رَبَّنَا إِنَّنَا سَمِعْنَا مُنَادِيًا يُنَادِي لِلْإِيمَانِ أَنْ آمِنُوا بِرَبِّكُمْ فَآمَنَّا رَبَّنَا فَاغْفِرْ لَنَا ذُنُوبَنَا وَكَفِّرْ عَنَّا سَيِّئَاتِنَا وَتَوَفَّنَا مَعَ الْأَبْرَارِ رَبَّنَا وَآتِنَا مَا وَعَدتَّنَا عَلَى رُسُلِكَ وَلَا تُخْزِنَا يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ إِنَّكَ لَا تُخْلِفُ الْمِيعَادَ. Indeed, in the creation of the heavens and the earth, and the alteration or alternation of night and day, there are signs for those who possess intellects. Those who remember Allah standing, sitting, and lying on their sides, and reflect on the creation of the heavens and the earth, and say, Our Lord, you have not created this in vain. ما خلقت هذا باطلا. Subhanak, immaculate are you. Save us from the punishment of the fire. Our Lord, whoever that you make enter the fire will surely have been disgraced by you, and the wrongdoers will have no helpers. Our Lord, we have indeed heard a summoner calling to the faith. Munadiyan yunadi lil iman. Someone's calling to faith. So we heard that person. What was he saying? Have faith in your Lord. So we believed. Our Lord, forgive us our sins and absolve us of our misdeeds and make us die with the pious. Like, so when we leave this world, take us as one of the pious ones with the pious ones. Our Lord, give us what you have promised us through your prophets, your apostles, and do not disgrace us on the day of resurrection. Indeed, you do not break your promise. All right, so as I said, these are some of my favorite verses because they are, of course, recited, as I said, before Salatul Layl. It's not necessary, but it's one of the etiquettes, you could say. But before talking about that a little bit, I want to talk about the verses themselves. Number one thing that really stands out, I really like, and some of our Mufassirin have pointed this out, it said, it started off with what? يَذْكُرُونَ اللَّهَ قِيَامًا وَقُعُودًا وَعَلَى جُنُوبِهِمْ. They are remembering Allah standing, sitting, lying on their sides, you know, when they want to go to sleep. So they have dhikrullah, they remember Allah. All right, these people who have dhikrullah, what do? يَتَفَكَّرُونَ فِي خَلْقِ السَّمَوَاتِ. So you have the heavens and the earth, the skies and the earth. And then you have the changing of night to day and day to night. These things that are happening, these natural phenomena, causes these people, yes, what do? They're ones who have dhikrullah in all states. Whether they're standing, they're sitting, they're sleeping, whatever it is, sleeping meaning laying down to sleep. Whatever it is, they have dhikrullah. These people, what do? Their dhikr, you can say, according to this verse, kind of leads to them doing fikr, tafakkur. So dhikr, then fikr. They think, they reflect over these signs of Allah. And they come to some wonderful conclusions that, oh Allah, all of this is happening. All of this is happening. It's not going to be in vain. There must be a purpose in all of this. Subhanaka, ma khalaqta hadha batilan. You didn't create all of this in vain. There's a purpose in it. So save us from the hellfire if we're going to be ones who are not going to achieve and secure this purpose of creation of everything. We seek refuge in Allah from that. And a person who you do not save from the hellfire, then you have really disgraced them. They are at the lowest of the lowest levels. إِنَّكَ مَنْ تُدْخِلِ النَّارَ فَقَدْ أَخْزَيْتَ. So we're seeking refuge in you from the hellfire. Why? Because a person who goes to the hellfire is at the lowest level of disgrace. The biggest loser of them all. And will they have help in the hellfire? No. وَمَا لِلظَّالِمِينَ مِنْ أَنصَارٍ. They don't even have help either. So they're the lowest of the low. No one can take their hand and bring them up. Oh Allah, this is the state of the people who don't secure the purpose of your creation. So now let us tell you what we're all about. Oh Allah, Rabbana. And it's interesting, and this is something the Mufassirin have pointed out, that look, this person who is saying these things keeps repeating Rabbana, 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 because this is an intimate conversation right now that one is having with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rabbana, Rabbana. And so here it says Rabbana. How about us? We just want you to know, O Allah, that we sami'na munadiyan yunadi. We heard the call and we accepted. That easy. Because look around us. There's all of this going on. It's not going to be in vain. There must be a purpose. And so when the caller called to you, we accepted the call. Now some might say, the caller is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. Some might say this might apply to all people of all times regarding the fitrah that they have. That flame that Allah has put in us to accept Allah. We look around us, we see creation. That should be more than enough for us to accept. To know at least that there's a God out there, and then that God will send us His prophets. So now that we have accepted the faith, O Allah, faghfir lana dhunubana wa kaffir anna sayyatina. Forgive us of our sins. Sometimes we might make mistakes, but we believe. So forgive our mistakes. Atina ma wa'adtana ala rusulik. Those promises that you made, give us those, inshallah. And don't disgrace us on the Day of Judgment. You're not someone who will go against His promise, of course. So this is this person talking to Allah. As I said, these are verses that are recited usually, and it might be a good idea to memorize them. These are and to memorize their meaning as well. Remember their meaning so when you're reciting them, you know what you're saying. So we have this etiquette of reciting these verses before Salatul Layl. So a person gets up, sleeps like half an hour or an hour sooner, so they can wake up an hour sooner or half an hour sooner or 20 minutes sooner than Fajr time, so they can pray Salatul Layl. And so it's nice to recite these. It takes like half a minute or a minute to recite it. But it gets you ready for Salatul Layl. This is who I'm going to. Look at the nighttime. Look at the stars. Look at the moon. Look at the silence. While everyone else is sleeping, these are verses that I'm reciting to Allah. There's a person by the name of Nawf al-Bikali. Nawf, he says in this hadith, كُنْتُ عِنْدَ أَمِيرِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. I was with Imam Ali alayhi salam one night. ذَاتَ لَيْلَةٍ فَقَامَ مِنْ فِرَاشِهِ. So he got up from his bed, or firash means wherever he was sleeping, that little mattress or whatever it was, a little cushion that might have been under him, a little rug that might have been under him. He got up from that. وَنَظَرَ إِلَى النُّجُومِ. He looked into the stars of the sky at night. ثُمَّ قَرَأَ آيَاتِ آلِ عِمْرَانِ إِنَّ فِي خَلْقِ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. Then he recited the verses of Surah to Ali Imran. Well, which ones? We have 200 verses in Ali Imran. He says, the ones that start with إِنَّ فِي خَلْقِ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. Indeed, in the creation of the heavens and the earth, those ones he recited. So he's getting ready for Salat al-Layl. ثُمَّ قَالَ يَا نَوْف. Hey Nawf, are you awake? You asleep? أَرَاقِدٌ أَنْتَ أَمْ رَامِقٌ. So, I mean, it shows that this Nawf was probably a close companion of Ali ibn Abi Talib alayhi salam, that Ali cares to wake him up in this time of night for ibadah as well, probably. But he gives him some words of wisdom. Because he says, فَقُلْتُ بَلْ رَامِقْ, I'm awake. يَا أَمِيرَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. So Amir al-Mu'mineen tells him, O Nawf, glad tidings. طُوبَ لِلزَّاهِدِينَ فِي الدُّنْيَا الرَّاغِبِينَ فِي الْآخِرَةِ. Glad tidings and good news for the ones who can care less about this dunya. Not that they don't do their job in this dunya. They do their job, they have a halal living, all that. But they're not in love with this dunya. They're not attached to this dunya. Good for them. الرَّاغِبِينَ فِي الْآخِرَةِ. The ones who are more interested in the akhirah, who are in love with the akhirah, are working for the akhirah. And the hadith goes on, of course. But in this context, I would say the best example for it of being interested in the akhirah is Salat al-Layl. Amir al-Mu'mineen in this hadith, he wakes up, he looks to the skies, looks to the stars, as the hadith said, and he recites these verses. I personally, especially in the month of Ramadan, for example, if anyone wants to at least pray Salat al-Layl in the month of Ramadan, I think Ramadan is the time to at least try to do that. And especially the nights of Qadr. You don't want the nights of Qadr to pass without having prayed Salat al-Layl. This is one of the most solid a'mal one can do throughout the year, especially in Ramadan, especially in the nights of Qadr. Okay? It's not a bad idea if a person wants to pray Salat al-Layl to go out or to look through the window at least. Look at the stars a little bit. Look at the sky. And then recite these verses, and then start, making their wudu for their salat, and so on.